Good day, fellas. This is your daily dose of skill. And what I noticed recently, I haven't played with the Leopard 1 for pretty much full year. So I believe it is about to give it a go and it is about to try to play with this vehicle. And before that, fellas, I noticed that we hit 100,000 subs and I'm very, very grateful for that. And tomorrow we are going to have Q&A session. I have a billion of the questions from your side, fellas. So I will answer everything. I will give you a quick preview of my life, if I can say so. I think it's going to be good. I think it's going to be enjoyable and I think it's going to be nice. So see you tomorrow. Tomorrow we are going to have Q&A once again, and probably there is quite some of you which want to know many questions to your answers, right? So tomorrow I will cover everything, and obviously quick yearly thanks for 100,000, fellas. This means a life for me, if I can say so, and I'm saying for a long time. I'm that lucky bugger which is living his dream, because it is definitely the case. And I am overall very, very, very happy, right? Just for understanding, fellas, in my city where I live, there is approximately 20,000 people, and we have 5 times more subs in the YouTube, which is effing insane. Anyways, I'm grateful for that. Thank you very much. And now we can start our journey with Leo 1. Without further ado, let's go. 3 battles. We are aiming for 4,500 plus combined score. And let's see what matchmaking is going to give for us in this yearly Sunday morning. When I'm recording the video, it is 11 a.m. I woke up at 9 to prepare mentally for this YouTube video. And since it is a Sunday, I have a lot of time to pre-make videos for next week. Hopefully, today is going to be a good day, right? That's the plan. Anyways, fellas, let's bloody go. So, the first battle, what do we have right here? We have 3 heavy tanks, we have plenty of medium tanks, couple of the tank destroyers, 2 light tanks, and 2 clickers. Not much what we can do about this. I believe the best play for Leo is to go into the middle. Why am I saying it is a best play for Leo? Because we can punish people which is trying to play around this area. The weirdest thing of all this, there is no Ferraris in this situation, which is actually quite weird considering matchmaking is floated by Ferraris, my lovely friends. First shot to the Super Conqueror, that's very good. We are going to keep shooting them over there. E100, shot into the side of the E100. You see, fellas, enemy team is very, very kind. They are taking one for the team. Like, all of those 3 heavy tanks which crossed here, they was extremely friendly. They said, okay, hit me once, after that hit me once, after that hit me once, and I am just farming them without even asking their names, and obviously that's the main plan of all this. Leo, as a tank, even though this vehicle is very, very powerful, in the same time, it's not the easiest tank to play with. What do I mean by saying that? If you are going to make a mistake, you are going to pay your price for your stupidity, and I truly mean it. Armor of the Leo is very, very, very debatable how good of the armor this vehicle has, right? The main point, by the way, you saw this one, this shot, that means they have mother trucker somewhere over there. And I'm giving yearly information for our team, because I know they have bushwhackers. Speaking about the bushwhackers, there is 140, and obviously if this 140 will think about something silly, we are going to punish him, right? As you can see, K91 is sniping from the back, 430U is making a hardcore pressure here, and obviously we are trying to support our team as much as we physically can, right, fellas? Focus on this one, fellas. This is very, very, very important. If this 140 is moving ahead, we are punishing him for his mistake. Ну давай, just move in front. I will be kind to you. I will hit you only once, okay? Speaking about hitting only once, there is a Leo 1 which is sitting right here. And what is my initial plan, obviously, is to hit this Leo. Good, 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 good. Leo got hit in the side, which is very, very nice, fellas. Relax, take it easy. We have a lot of time left. I am still being here, and this is safe. This is kind of safe from the people which is playing over there, although there is one... downside from this strategy, right? What do I mean about saying the downside from this strategy? If Arta will start focusing me, and eventually Arta can start focusing me, then we are going to have a bit of the troubles. Speaking about the troubles, the key 91 is sitting in the deep shithole, especially if he would decide to make a bit of the pressure right here. So that would be very, very good for us. Speaking about the good things for us, how about if this Leo will die? Good. Leo is dead. Trashbone, please don't punish me for my stupidity. I beg you. Thank you very much. So, the start of this battle. First 3.5 minutes, we have 3,400 damage dealt. We have 22 assisting damage, which is always welcome and always nice. And once again, we are simply waiting until enemies are going to make a pressure. What Leopard is. Leopard is a tank. It is like a glass cannon in a way. What that means? That means we have a very, very beautiful gun, but what we do not have armor. And speaking about that, Fava managed to find the shot into like half of the tank, right? That's completely fine. I am feeling still very, very, very happy. We managed to farm 4,700. It's not the greatest score, but it is not the worst score either. And it worked just fine for us. So this, as you can see, this Trashburn is farming everyone which is playing over there, and this Trashburn probably farmed the guy which was going like this. I'm speaking about our 279E. It's a okay, not a big deal, fellas. I am feeling good, but in the same time, I feel like this might be a defeat for us. What is the worst thing of all this, fellas? This TVP read the map quite well. He went in front and he bursted me for 1,200 damage, and then enemy Fava simply finished us. But that's completely fine. The first pancake is great. See you in a second when the game will be over. And we are back. Not a big surprise, like I said before, we are going to lose this battle, and for this victory, I would say TVP is responsible for this victory. He F'd me well, I had full hit points, but then quickly I got bursted, and then Trashburn obviously killed me. Who is the hero of this battle? Speaking about the score, probably Fava have the most damage and TVP have the most combined score, because he was potting for that guy for all the time, and I believe Trashburn hit quite a bit of the Trashburn have at least 5,000 damage. This would be my prediction. Let's see, am I correct or I am incorrect? So... I am incorrect. Paton farmed 4,200, Fava farmed 3,500, and speaking about the TVP, one thing he did in this battle, he actually clipped me. Okay, I was incorrect. Anyways, doesn't matter, we have a great score, 4,700 damage, our team did not perform too well, we are top by experience and top by the damage, which is very, very, very good thing for us, fellas, don't you think so? Let's continue. I learned that a hard way, fellas. Winning all the time is definitely not an option in the current World of Tanks. Believe me, it is just not the case. I wish to say every single of us could influence the win, but it is a team play after all, right? And when you are playing 15 against the 15, you are 1/15th part of the team. Obviously, it's important how much of the influence you can make, but usually, if enemy team is way stronger, it doesn't matter what kind of tank you are playing, what map you are playing, and so on, you are not going to win this. If enemy team is way, way, way stronger. So, you know, for me, victory, defeat, it is just a name overall. Believe me, just how it goes. Yes, obviously, everyone is having the days when they are winning 80% of the battles or when they have 20% win ratio. I'm not exception for that. So, you know, It is how it is. Anyways, what do we have now? We have the Corridor Pass, one of the shitter maps if you would ask me. And obviously, with this much making, which is three light tanks and three brown shits, this is not looking great by any means, my friends. This is not looking great. But it's not changing the fact we will try to give our best, right? We will try to punish enemies every single time, obviously, when they can be punished, and we will use our 420 alpha damage. Speaking about the damage overall with this vehicle, the gun handling is actually perfect on this tank. It is very, very, very good. Speaking about the shell velocity, 1.5 kilometers, which is humongous shell velocity. And after that, if we would pay attention at the gold shells have 1.6 kilometer shell velocity, or 1,600 meters, or 1 mile shell velocity. Holy bananas from Banana Land, that's very, very good. What is not so good about this battle, fellas? What is happening around us? What do I mean by saying that? I am immediately reacting into the current situation, right? As you can see, our team is melting right here. Our team is melting right here. This is no bueno. Plus, on top of that, unfortunately, but we cannot make a pressure like this, or maybe we can make a pressure like this, but it's not going to be overall good idea, at least in my opinion, right? So there is nowhere to go. Jack Pizda is simply going to wait for us, and he is going, and those Jack Pizdas are going to farm us from over there. So it's simply not a good idea to do anything right here. So only one call, what we actually have here is to try to outspot people which is playing around this area. Hopefully we will spot this TVP, which is going to make just tiny touch more pressure. Our trash burn or our any other tank destroyer is going to punish them, and then we can smile, right? Other than that, boys, we are in the deep shithole, my friends. Otherwise, we are in the deep shithole. Remember the story which I told you before? Jack Peasley is going to wait for someone to punish... Jack Peasley is going to wait here on the corner. Yep, our IS-4 is fighting against Jack Peasley. And if he's going to be lucky, obviously, he's going to penetrate Jack Peasley. But in the same time, if Jack Peasley is shooting the hit, which usually Jack Peasleys are doing, it's not going to be very, very, very fun situation. Don't you think so? Speaking about not so fun situation, 2-4, and our team, speaking about the positioning, is giving literally all positions for the enemy team. So this is very, very, very horrible score, and it's not the best map for the Leo overall. This map is good for meatballs, the tanks which have some hit points, which have some armor, and so on. If you are playing with a tank like Leo, it's definitely not the place where you want to be, my friends. At least this is my opinion. Speaking about my opinion, unfortunately we did not manage to penetrate the almighty AMAX, but it's not changing too many things, fellas. I loaded high explosive ammunition. Why did I did that? Because I have a chance to penetrate this STB-1 here, right? Speaking about penetration, Schnei, 500 in the face of the STB-1. STB-1 is on the full rampage right here, and he managed to track me, but it's not changing too much things for us, fellas, believe me. Another penetration for the STB, and now STB is down to 200 hit points. Obviously, he's going to hit me once again, but I truly don't really mind about it, and we are finishing him into cupola. Well, I thought I'm going to finish him into cupola, but I did not manage to do so. That's completely fine. Meanwhile, EBR is going to approach our team here super aggressively. At least that's what I want to believe, but we'll see. Maybe we can still have some kind of comeback. What do you think, fellas? What is the chance we can have some kind of comeback over the year? Speaking about EBR, EBR is going like crazy mosquito, blah, 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 like this. And you know what? This MIX still could be around this area. So let's see what we can do. Meanwhile, what is happening, fellas? Leo 1 is thinking how to approach our team from over there. At least that's what I believe, and that's how the things is looking like. Leo is right here. We punished him for 440 damage, which is always welcome and always nice. Since he's tracked, we are going to eliminate him from the game, and he's dead. Beautiful. Next, what do we want to do? We want to wait for a couple of seconds until we can take this position over there, right? But unfortunately, it's not the case, and we cannot do that because Arta punished us for our stupidity. That was quite silly goose move from my side, but I deserved what I got. So what do we want to do now? E100. We need to spot this E100 somehow, so our Artas could punish him for his mistake right here. Meanwhile, we managed to penetrate into his ear, the small tiny bit of the tank, which is extremely good thing for us. Meanwhile, Jack Pizda hit the Fava for 1000 hit points, and he have only 420 HP left. Can we eliminate him from the game? That's the question. Meanwhile, Arta is dead. Beautiful. We are eliminating guns, fellas. We are trying to eliminate as many guns as we can. At least that's the main plan for us, right? And speaking about the main plan, how about shooting this Jack Pizda, which is going like crazy mosquito like this. 420 in the face. One of the clickers is dying, but it's not changing too much. We are still farming the same Jack Pizda. He just shot. He thinks I do not know he's on the reload. And believe me, I know, buddy. I know. You cannot do anything about that. And Mr. Jack Pizda is sitting on 180 HP. Now, fellas, when we have 3,800 damage right here, can we get some more use? That's the most important question of this battle. Can we get some more use? I'm waiting until this E100 is going to make a bit of pressure, and as you can see, he is making a bit of pressure right here. So what we are going to do ourselves, we will try to craft a better position to punish this guy, and E100 just shot. What it is giving for us? It is giving for us opportunity to shoot him twice. Too bad I messed up by shooting my very first shot, but I deserved what I deserved, fellas. I repeat, I deserved what I deserved. Meanwhile, our EBR is distracting this huge meatball in the field, and we are just farming him. We are not asking his name, we are farming him. That's the most important thing. While this guy working as a distraction, we need to pump as much damage as we physically and possibly can. Meanwhile, the EBR is over there, but it's not changing anything, and this guy is dead. Beautiful play by our EBR. Meanwhile, enemy EBR is saying the same thing. Mother trucker, I will kill you, mother trucker, and he's blah, 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 going like this. Once again, that's completely fine for us because enemy AMAX is going to die in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, he's dead. Beautiful. Meanwhile, I'm going to load the high explosive ammunition for enemy EBR, and we are going to make a massive pressure. EBR is over there. I'm trying to punish him into the side. Too bad I did not manage to penetrate him with high explosive, but it doesn't matter because game is over. G-effing-G, fellas. That was good play, EBR. EBR, fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, this beautiful mosquito, what he have done over there by trolling this E100, we won not because of me, we won because of the EBR. He gave the perfect distraction. Also, I need to give a credit for our Jack Pizda. This Jack Pizda, fellas, he hoarded like a truck full of dildos, okay? That Jack Pizda, which sitted over there, he holded everyone which is going to make a pressure like this, right? So it was perfect. It was perfection, fellas. I'm super happy what we managed to do, considering what kind of map do we have, right? And once again, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we have a corridor pass. The map which is definitely not the best for... the Leopard, right? But still, that was very good. Big thumbs up for our Valentina, which was going like, and obviously it worked just great. So that's good to see. Okay, fellas. Yee, victory. Skill, you said not to be excited about victory defeat. Oh, you don't see that? Okay. Oh, yeah. I am happy with the small things, okay? Once again, speaking about the score, Ace Vanker, DR 5,600 damage, 1,100 assisting damage, and our hero of the day, EBR, he did a bloody great job, and his name was Andrei. Thank you very much for a battle, buddy. Okay, let's continue. Last battle with Leo 1. Let's keep it up, and it's going to be a bloody full session. In the same time, fellas, speaking about Leo 1 overall, this tank is created to play safe in a way. You have extremely good gun, you can punish enemies for their stupidity, just simply aim and shoot, aim and shoot, aim and shoot. That's all you need to do with this vehicle, my lovely friends. That's all you need to do with this tank. Okay, only one Arta, only one light tank. This is looking like a decent matchmaking already, fellas. This is looking like a decent matchmaking. Plus, on top of that, enemies have the light tank, which is bloody T49. What T49 means, usually T49 is having a derp guns, and they are not the full vision on their tanks, because they want to maximize the gun handling as much as they can. What that means? That means we have advantage over field, at least in my opinion. Unless majority of our guys is going to go into the city, which is definitely the case. Huh. Okay. What is the plan for us in this battle? We are not going to rush here. We are going to be very, very, very smart. At least I hope we are going to be smart. And what we are doing, we are taking a typical bush ride there. I know it might not seem like it is the case, but it is. This bush can work very, very well when enemies are trying to approach you like this, or even like this. It doesn't really matter. Yes, the flexibility is not the finest, it's not the best one, but at least we can get a bit of the use here. And this is relatively safe. Speaking about relatively safe, you see where enemy T49 is? I have a feeling, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, I have a feeling enemies do not have too many people over there. I truly believe in that. So how we are going to figure out the things? Meanwhile, the tier 9 is getting spotted, which is not a big deal for us whatsoever. Progetto is banging our light tank, which is once again not too bad. Now, if I'm going to get spotted, that means they have a person over there. But as you can see, I am not getting spotted. So that's completely fine. Speaking about the things which is fine, there is Esterva, which is sitting in the middle of the field, and we are getting assisting damage out of him, which is very, very good, fellas. All we need to do, we need to simply calm down, and we need to try to punish him every single time when he's going to make a mistake, and believe me, he will. Meanwhile, our 3090 is showing how scout's supposed to play in this map, and he is actually going extremely aggressively, and he is giving us every advantage which we could ever want from Leo, right? By saying that, I mean we are getting the eyes on the enemies, and that's the most important thing for us, right? Speaking about the eyes, Esterva is dead. Beautiful. How about the Leo 1? Maybe we could hit him. Unfortunately, we can't. Okay, fellas, what we need to do, we need to make a pressure. We need to make a pressure for that CS-59. Come on, let's go. I truly want to make, actually, I was thinking about making pressure, but I changed my mind. Why did I change my mind? Answer is extremely simple, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Because it's simply not worth to make a pressure. It is literally impossible to make a pressure. In fact, what I'm going to do now, I'm going to relocate from here completely. Why am I going to do this? I think this is the right way to play this battle. Let's count the guns. Enemies have 5 guns over there. We have 4 guns over there, plus enemy artillery supporting this side. So how about if we are going to show a big fat middle finger for everyone which is having a safe defense parameter over there, and we would go into the heavy line, right? I believe we are winning the heavy line here, so maybe we could actually perform well, right? Maybe we can destroy the heavy tanks which is playing around this area. What do you think? Speaking about mistakes, fellas, enemy T49 is making a humongous mistake over there. We are trying to punish him. That was a perfect shot from the horror movie for the T49, and luckily we punished him. Nice. Okay, how about if we are making, if we would make a bit of the pressure for the, okay, I need to have a gold ammunition right there. Why do I need to have a gold ammunition? I kind of want to punish the Super Conqueror, which is sitting right there next to the window. And speaking about the window, object just shot, which is completely fine. I'm not complaining too much. I will have a pixel here if he's going to peek in the same way as he did before. And I want to believe he's going to do that. Actually, not really. He's not going to do this thing. I cannot do anything for Object 705A. I repeat, I cannot do anything for Object 705A. How about if we would... Wait. This is very, very, very hard situation for us. We can't do shit for him. Okay. Patience, patience, patience is the key, fellas. Patience is the key. How about if I will peek like this? Obviously, he's going to be prepared for me, but that's completely fine. He's right here. That's okay. We are keeping him spotted, so our clicker could potentially hit him, right? And once again, I am just simply being patient here. I do not want to make a critical mistake when we are being sent to the hill, like immediately. It's just simply not worth it. Meanwhile, I believe this guy, he's thinking about the side overall. So what we are doing, we are making a hardcore pressure like this, and we should be able to eliminate this guy from the game in approximately a second. This guy is dead. Excellent. How about if we would try to eliminate Super Conqueror? Super Conqueror shot me once, but it's not changing anything because he is dead. We pick up the two important kills in my opinion, and now what we can do, we can try to shit on this Fava. Speaking about Fava shitting, fellas, I need to have high explosives. Why so? Because we want to hit him for 500 if it's possible, but he's dead already. Very, very unfortunate thing, but oh well, what can we do? Next. What do we want to do now? We want to load the standard ammunition, and we are obviously making a pressure. Now, look. In my eyes, fellas, this battle was good. Why this battle was good by overall, even though our performance is not the greatest one? One thing which I want to say right here is very, very simple. We realized what is the weaker flank from the enemy side, right? And we made a hardcore pressure towards the weaker flank. This is all we needed to do. Well, hardcore pressure. We were simply playing smart there, right? And this is exactly what we wanted to do, fellas. And this is exactly what we needed to do. And this is beautiful RAM for us. Nice. Can we eliminate him from the game? Unfortunately, no, we can't. But it's not changing anything. Meanwhile, we are spotting enemy Arta, which is aiming for us. And enemy Arta is complaining because he's down to one shotable. And all we need to do now, we need to go for Leo 1 and we need to go for 263. Why Leo 1 as a tank is powerful, even though it is a hard tank to play with? Leo 1 have ability to relocate, Leo 1 have a good gun handling, Leo 1 is a good bushwanker sniper schnitzel, and you can get a lot of bloodyful things with this tank by the default, right? Just because of the combination of the things, which is once again extremely important, at least in my eyes, right? At least in my eyes, it is extremely important. Speaking about important things, Arta is dead. That's good. Enemy Leo is sitting right here, which is not a big deal for us. We are punishing him. He is punishing us. We are down to one shotable. Leo is down to one shotable. Although, more likely, he's going to reload first, so I'm not going to rush for him yet. But in the same time, I'm thinking about banging the object. Object took one for the team, and Leo is dead. 6.1000 combined, 5.2000 damage, 7, actually 900 assisting damage. Fellas, you can say whatever flying F you want, we played well. Even though the start of the battle was quite slow, but in the end of the game we managed to, we figured out how we need to make a pressure and how the flying F do we need to do the things. And you know what? Here you go. Leo, one in action. Tell me this tank is bad, mother truckers. Tell me this vehicle is bad. Very, very, very good game. We break even. Actually, we make 20,000 credits. And overall, from this session, in total, we made 144,000 credits. We have 5.1000 average damage and 700 assisting damage, which is bringing us to close to 6,000 combined. Such a beautiful performance, fellas. I hope I made your Sunday just a bit better. I hope you got some tips and tricks how to play with Leo 1. And thank you so much for watching. Tomorrow, special video, 100,000 edition Q&A session. So it's going to be beautiful. Thank you very much and see you very, very soon, fellas. Skill is out. Peace.